Welcome back to Let's Play The World Ends With You. In the last part we started playing as Neku Sakuraba, which pretty much just woke up in the middle of the street here, and we were attacked by frogs, which were called Noise, and we met Shiki Misaki and formed a pact with her, and we can now shoot fire pretty much, or make flame pillars, something like this. And it seems like we're part of a Reaper game, but Neku still doesn't really believe it, which is kinda understandable, I guess, but he's still being a bit of a jerk. Anyway, we have to go up here to 10-4. Made it! The timer vanished. Phew, mission complete. Big deal.
What?
Only an idiot would screw up on day one. Who's there? Oh no, a Reaper? Reaper. You two are gonna get erased sooner or later. So come on, help a girl out and earn me a few extra points, okay? This monster's again. Neku, you know how to fight now, right? This time, focus your thoughts on me. What? Fight your own battles. Please, to stop the noise. Fine. Come on. So, this time, we have Shiki, and we have to press the left or right on the control pad, and have Shiki attack in that direction. She has this weird combo map, to get these cards at the end, depending on which combo. If I pick two times right, then up, and then right again, I get the plus, for example, on if I had this. It doesn't really matter much at this point, but later on we get extra points where we have to pretty much get certain cards. And to get the certain cards, we have to see if we can get it. And as it said here, we don't have to actually use her. After a while, after we don't use her, she attacks on herself. Which is pretty important, because I guess we can see it now. We can battle with both at the same time. And actually looking at both screens at the same time is pretty difficult. Even if you just hit in one direction with Shiki. She learns certain things. She can't move around like Neku, but she can jump later on and block some attacks, but she's pretty much standing in the middle all the time and can just attack to left and right. Which makes the battle on her side pretty ineffective in my eyes. But yeah, whatever. Good, now we can fight together. We can beat the noise faster as a team. Let's do this. Now we actually get our HP, gotch. We have 1 HP, and if Shiki is hit, the HP goes down from the upper side, and if Neku is hit, it gets up from the lower side, and once the green bar is gone from whatever, then we die. If Neku doesn't take damage, but Shiki all the time, it just goes straight down till we don't have anything. And yeah, then there is the green light puck. If we make a combo, the puck goes to the other player, then his attack is increased, like you can see here, 3 times attack. And then when she made her combo, it goes back to Neku, and then his attacks do more damage. And yeah. That's pretty much the same for the enemies. They have 1 HP gauge as well. And yeah, I guess it's explained later, but I can say it now as well. While Shiki and Neku fight, they can't actually see each other. And if you hit the opponent on the upper screen, it doesn't happen anything on the lower screen except you beat it, of course. That's because they are like fighting in alternate dimensions or something. And some noise are pretty much just appearing on one dimension and the other on this dimension, and so they have to fight together, so yeah, pretty much they can win. Anyway, there are some special opponents where this is explained better. So now Neko has the slide plug, for example. And now Shiki has it. And the battle's over. I'm actually going to later on let Shiki battle on herself, because it's way easier to do this. Is it over? Not yet, Neko! Over there! Phew, this one looks tough. Like I've got a choice. Hey, stalker! I'm not a stalker! Whatever, just don't mess this up. I won't. Hey, stalker. Oh man.
Your good is gone.
Again. Yeah. Oh, come on. Ow.
Be careful. Again. Be careful. Who's next?
I just had to concentrate a bit, because playing with two screens is really difficult, and I still am really bad at it, even on the normal DS, and I pretty much never use Shiki on myself. Obtained Scarletide. Phew, we did it. But you heard her, day one is nothing. What if the missions only get harder? You've got 6 more days. Are we gonna make it? I don't want to be erased. I can't believe this. Why am I stuck here? What if I'm erased? What the hell kind of game is this? This can't be right. Ah! I'm really stuck here. In Shibuya? Yes, we are. The first day, Reaper's game. Chapter closed. And yeah, we can here see our character stats, Esper ranks, only human, Esper points, noise report, pin mastery, item collection, final time attack. I'm actually not that good on my own DS game. I played very much, but I still haven't finished noise report and pin mastery and all that stuff. So I'm not gonna make it here either, but I'm pretty much showing as much as I can, but there are some things that I don't really know of. Yeah. For now, we're gonna save our progress. Save completed. And we're going to the second day. Already.
Yeah.
Nah. Where am I now? I hope this works out. Hey! Ah! Don't scare me like that! Grow up. You're obnoxious. Is something wrong? Where are we? Isn't this the underpass by the station? I can hear the trains. That's weird. How'd we get here? That's the mission! Set the cursed sculpture free. You have 60 minutes. Fail and face Erasure, the Reapers. Timer's back. What's it for? The mission. You really don't know? If we don't clear the mission before the timer hits zero, we'll both be erased. Sounds crazy to me. But maybe not that crazy. I saw it happen to those people at by the station. It met a Reaper. Can't believe I'm even entertaining that thought. But I know what I heard. Wait. Why did dates change on my phone? They must have gone by. What? I think we fell asleep after the mission. But that's okay, we need to focus on today. Have you lost your mind? It's anything but okay. We were in the middle of the street. In broad daylight. Why would he fall asleep? So, this cursed sculpture. It's gotta be talking about the statue of Hachiko. Maybe we passed out. And then woke up here? Everything in between is a blank. But then, what's the curse? Neko? Did somebody drag us here, or... Neko has pretty much his own problems at the moment. Come on, Neko, pay attention!
Hey!
Hey, what, now you're ignoring me? If we don't work together, we fail the mission! Don't have to be like this. What am I doing wrong? Alright, no point in standing here. Let's go find Hachiko. Okay, we're pretty much doing this. And here's again a guy we can talk to. He doesn't say anything. Where have I seen this guy before? Neko, Hachiko's this way! Come on! For yourself.
Open up your senses.
Scan, but nothing's here. And here's another wall. Ah! What? Another wall? So now we're trapped in here. No, we'll never finish the mission now. All she ever does is whine. Why not? Because this is the way to Hachiko. And we have to get through. We got past the wall yesterday. Is there some kind of rule? What should we do? Don't just stand there. Think of something. I am thinking. Maybe if for just 1 minute, you could stop your be... Huh? Neko, what is it? That guy in the red hoodie. I've seen him before. Neko, what are you looking at? That guy? You know him? I remember. He was at the crossing yesterday by the wall. Who is he? I'm gonna try reading his mind. While in the field, touch the scan pin at the lower right bottom of the screen to protect the scanning field and read people's minds. Yeah, we already got that. But, as we can see, we can't read his mind. What is it? I can't read him.
What?
What? You can't read him? You can't scan him? I had no trouble scanning people yesterday. Maybe the rules changed? Or maybe the pin is broken. Can we finish the mission without being able to scan? What if it's just him? Maybe he's special. Neko! What now? That guy is coming right toward us. You, scan and erase all the noise in this area. Huh? What are you talking about? Are those the conditions to move on? I don't see any noise. The world is more than just what you see. He left. What a creepy guy. I don't know what his deal is, but he's part of the game, that's for sure. Which can mean only one thing. Interesting. His kind can be scanned. The world is more than just what you see. So, to find the noise... Hey, let's get rid of the noise. How? They're not here. Yes, they are. We have to scan for them. You think? Alright, let's try it. But first... I meant to ask you... Shouldn't you try some other pins? You've got more, right? Pins? Yeah, they should have given you a whole bunch. You're right, in my pocket. Why not test them out? How? Remember the flame pin yesterday? This one? Well, I wasn't able to use it. So maybe... I get it. Certain pins only work for certain people. I've got to try them all and see. Talk about a hassle. Alright, let's see what I can do. So yeah, we have to scan for the noise, which I meant with the parallel dimension. And we have to beat those three at the moment. So, the two pins Neku is wearing activate with a touch. Quickly tap an enemy to strike it with lightning. Or tap a part of the touchscreen to fire a bullet. Yeah. The first pin we have at the left is and we see we have no HP again. It's lightning, we have to directly touch the enemy. And then a lightning comes down. If you touch it multiple times, then there is a combination. And for the other pin we just have to click once in free space to shoot pretty much. Very useful pin, and I just screwed up. Okay, we're back in the fight. I'm not sure what I did, but I clicked definitely at the wrong part of the auto screen. And that pretty much turned out to let this whole thing run down. But yeah, we got the Thunderbolt and the Force Rounds. And the Force Rounds is a really cool type of Psych. It's one of my favorites, actually. But we should try out another one, which I really like, I guess. Okay, the obstacle pin.
Watch yourself.
We can take this and pretty much throw it around. The bigger the object, the stronger it is, and the more damage it does.
So, who's next?
If we're just throwing around the fence, it doesn't do as much damage as when we throw around the car or whatever, which is possible with it. So yeah, but pretty much this pin is in general very strong, but you have to rely on objects which aren't always there. This is pretty much the pin I like the most. You just have to, how to explain it. You click on the screen, just drag it fast and let it go. If you can hear the mouse, for example. And you can hear it on this as the thing as well. You just have to click fastly and then rush over it. And if you do it again and again and again, you can slash. This is pretty much how it works. But yeah, this might be a pretty difficult one to pull off in this. If I can't really control the mouse, that's the thing. Because if I go out of the screen, of course, I have to go back and stuff like that. You're right, we have to scan to see the noise. Lady Gex takes care of them all. Objective met. But what about the wall? It's still... Huh? It's gone. Why? Because we took out the noise. So, that's a trick to getting past the walls. But that's odd. What's odd? I heard you could only beat the noise in pairs. But I fought them alone. Me too. Oh yeah, that's now this parallel universe things. I couldn't see you while I was fighting. Because he was in another in the other zone. Huh? The noise exists simultaneously in two zones. And the only way to defeat them is purging them from both. Wait, but... What is with this guy? He knows too much. He must be one of them. Well, anyway, you did great. What? You were able to use all the pins. How were you? How can she even know if she didn't see us fight? So? You're like some kind of psych genius. Ah, come on. Using a couple of pins doesn't make anyone a genius. Don't be naive. The bigger question is where these came from. Huh? Neku, you have two player pins. Yep. This and this. So? So, why two? You only need one. How should I know? Why do I have any of them? I need them for psychs, so I can stop the noise killing from killing me. But how'd I get them? Two is better than one. So, like, don't feel bad. You're the one who said I only need one. Think how lucky I am. My partner's a psych whiz. A genius. You're a genius, Neku. I'd never make it without you. If you're going to flatter someone, you could try to sound a little genuine. Neku, you listening? Stop that, I'm trying to be nice. I'm listening. Well, how am I supposed to tell when you're just stand there? You should take off these headphones. It's rude. Will you shut the hell up? I just met you, I don't like you. And don't give a rat's ass if you think I'm rude. You don't have to yell. What am I going to do? As I said, we are pretty much an asshole at the moment. Now she's playing with the phone? Forget this. But there is actually an explanation for it later on. Hey, wait up! Wheels. While the field, touch the mail icon in the upper left corner to see the mission objective. Yeah, we already know that. What we can do is click here, which is pretty bad at the start. But I guess we can do it now. Neku, stop! Wait for me! And we are waiting for her till the next episode. See ya!